they got caught with their hands in the cookie jar, turning Medicare into a piggy bank for Obamacare. Their own actuary from the administration came to Congress and said, one out of six hospitals and nursing homes are going to go out of business as a result of this.
That's not what they said.
7.4 million seniors are projected to lose the current Medicare Advantage coverage they have. That's a $3,200 benefit cut.
That didn't
what we're
happen.
Saying,
more people signed up.
These are
up.
From your own
more,
actuaries.
More people signed up for Medicare Advantage after
what,
the change.
What they're
no,
saying,
nobody is.
Mr. Vice President,
down.
I know.
No, this
Mr. Vice President,
this is
I know
little...
you're under a lot of duress to make up for lost ground. But I think people will be better served if we don't keep interrupting each other.
Well, now, don't just, take all the 4 minutes then.
We're saying don't change benefits for people 55 and above. They already organize their retirement around these promises. Already,
well, let me ask you this. What is your specific plan for seniors who really can't afford to make up the difference in the value of what you call a premium support plan and others call a voucher?
100% coverage
and
for them.
What
that's
it would
what
cost,
we're saying. So we're saying income adjust these premium support payments by taking down the subsidies for wealthy people. Look, this is a plan. By the way, that $6,400 number, it was misleading then. It's totally inaccurate now. This is a plan that's bipartisan. It's a plan I put together with a prominent Democrat senator from Oregon.
There's not one Democrat who endorses
plan.
It. Not one Democrat who signed
our partner
the plan.
Is a Democrat from Oregon.
And he said he does no longer support
we
you
put it,
for that.
We put it together with the former Clinton budget director.
Who
this
disavows
idea,
it.
This idea came from the Clinton Commission to Save Medicare, chaired by Senator John Breaux. Here's the point, Martha.
Which was rejected.
If we don't fix this problem pretty soon, then current seniors get cut. Here's the problem. 10,000 people are retiring every single day in America today, and they will for 20 years. That's not a political thing.
Martha,
that's
if
a
we just
thing.
Did one thing, if they just allow Medicare to bargain for the cost of drugs like Medicaid can, that would save $156 billion right off the bat.
And it would deny seniors choices.
Seniors are not denied.
Absolutely.
They are not denied. Look, folks, all you seniors out there, have you been denied choices? Have you lost Medicare Advantage?
Because it's working well right now.
Or have you signed up? Because
Vice President Biden, let me ask you, if it could help solve the problem, why not very slowly raise the Medicare eligibility age by 2 years, as Congressman Ryan suggests?
Look, I was there when we did that with Social Security in 1983. I was one of eight people sitting in the room that included Tip O'Neill negotiating with President Reagan. We all got together and everybody said, as long as everybody's in the deal, everybody's in the deal, and everybody is making some sacrifice, we can find a way. We made the system solvent to 2033. We will not, though, be part of any voucher plan eliminating it. The voucher says, Mom, when you're 65, go out there, shop for the best insurance you can get. You're out of Medicare. You can buy back in, if you want, with this voucher, which will not keep pace. Will not keep pace with health care costs. Because if it did keep pace with health care costs, there would be no savings. That's why they go the voucher. We will be no part of a voucher program or the privatization of Social Security.